Yes, students. So this is not a new topic for you. You have read it in your previous classes as well. So it will be a quick revision of the topic, active and passive voice. So now this is the statement that is in front of you. Mr. Biswas renovated this house recently. That means Mr. Biswas, he has done some work, and what is that? Renovation of the house. So if we stand this in perspective, that Mr. Biswas is the doer here. And this word renovated is the verb here, which is in second form. And this house is the object here on which the action is performed, right? This house was renovated by Mr. Biswas recently. The statement is written in a different way, but the see the meaning is still the same. This house is still the receiver of the action, which is performed by Mr. Biswas, and that is the renovation of the house. But here we see a few changes are there. Right, this writing form has changed. There is a change in the verb. There is change in the position of the subject and the object. Then we see a new word is added there, that is by. Okay. So when we talk of voice, what exactly voice is? It is the form of the verb that shows whether the subject of the sentence does the action or is affected by it. So when the subject of a sentence does the action, it is said to be in active voice, right? And when it is affected by it, then it is called it is to be in passive voice. So what is a subject? Again, this is not a new thing for you, a person or a thing that we are talking about who is doing the action. Then what is the object? Who will tell? Subject hai, a person or a thing about whom which we are talking or who is doing the action. So what is the object? Rishika, can you tell what is the object? Object kya hota hai? Arshpreet Singh, if you can tell. Yes, Rishika, continue. Anji.
Object is the after the verb in the sentence, and it tells about the action or the person is doing.
Not exactly, it tells about the person, or we can say object. It is a person or a thing on which action is done, or the receiver of the action. Mr. Biswas renovated this house. Mr. Biswas ka action kya hai? Renovation of the house. So renovate kar rahe hai ghar. To action kis par ho raha hai? Ghar pe ho raha hai na? So receiver of the action or person or a thing on which action is done is the object, right? So in active and passive voice, it is very important to understand. Voice may active hai, that means what the subject does. The statement is in active voice when the subject is the doer. In passive form, the focus is on more on action. Ram killed Ravan. Here we are actually talking about Ram who killed Ravan. In passive, Ravan was killed by Ram. Now your focus is on Ravan. The action which was performed on Ravan, who was killed by Ram here. Right? So James hit the ball. In this sentence, James ne jo ball ko hit kiya, hit is an active voice. Aur hum ye kaise keh sakte hain? It shows that the subject, James, did the action. So it is an active voice. The ball was hit by James. The ball was, it is in passive form. In other words, it means that it shows that subject, the ball, it was affected by the action of James. And it is in passive voice, right? So how to change from active to passive? Ram killed Ravan. That means Ram is subject here. Killed is the verb and Ravan is the object. So when we transform it into passive voice, see what are the changes that we undergo. Ravan was killed by Ram. There is a change in the verb. There is a change in this place of the subject and object. And by is added. That means subject ne object ki jagah le li. Object ne subject ki jagah le li. And one thing is to be taken care of, that only transitive verb can have passive form. Transitive verb kya hote hai? That takes an object. Veena is singing. Veena is singing what? Iske saath koi object nahi laga hua hai. So this is not a transitive verb. Is singing is not a transitive verb. So it cannot be transformed into passive form. But if we add an object with it, Veena is singing a song. Veena is singing what? A song. Then it can be transformed into passive form as a song is being sung by Veena. So this has to be taken care of. So what are the steps that has to be taken care of while transforming from active to passive is bring the object first in place of the subject and send the subject in place of object. Choose the correct be form of the verb. That means you have to change the form of the verb. Keep this in mind, the tense of the verb will not change. It is just that the form of the verb is changed according to the passive voice. Then change the verb into past participle. It is the main verb. Be means here the helping verb. Appropriate helping verb is to be added. Then this verb, main verb, is to be changed into third form and add by with the subject. Jaise she helps him. Now ye jo sentence hai, it is in what tense? Kaun sa tense hai ye sentence ka? What is the tense? Tell me.
Simple present.
Simple past.
Simple present. Good. Present indefinite or simple present. So ye jo simple present hai, aap dekhiye isme changes kaise hue hain. हमने क्या करना है, ऑब्जेक्ट को पहले लाना है. तो हिम का ऑब्जेक्ट बन गया ही सब्जेक्ट में, शी बन गया हर. दोनों के प्लेसेस इंटरचेंज हो गए. अब करेक्ट फॉर्म ऑफ बी फॉर्म लगाना है विद द वर्ब. नाउ एज इट इज द फॉर्म ऑफ सिंपल प्रेजेंट, हमें इज एम आर लगाना पड़ेगा. सो हेल्प्स बन गया, उसके साथ हेल्पिंग वर्ब लगा इज. हेल्प्ड बन गया द थर्ड फॉर्म ऑफ द वर्ब. बाय लगाकर हमने कर दिया, जो सब्जेक्ट था शी उसको ऑब्जेक्ट में रख के. सो ही इज हेल्प्ड बाय हर. सो दिस इज द मेजर फाइव स्टेप्स. दीज आर द मेजर फाइव स्टेप्स दैट वी हैव टू रिमेम्बर. फर्स्ट स्टेप क्या कहता है, स्वॉप द पोजीशन ऑफ सब्जेक्ट एंड ऑब्जेक्ट. एड करेक्ट हेल्पिंग वर्ब बिफोर द मेन वर्ब. Convert the main verb into the verb third form and add preposition before the subject by preposition. So these are the five steps. First is the identifying subject, object and verb. If you are able to identify the correct verb, then it will be easier for you to transform it into passive. Okay? And just a quick review of this table. When you are transforming from active to passive, you have to change the subject into object, and the object of I is me, we is us, you remains you, they, them, he, him, she, her. Proper noun remains proper noun, book common noun remains common noun. And is the vice versa. If object is me, subject will become I, us, we, you, them, they, him, he, her, she. The proper noun will remain proper noun and the common noun will remain common noun. Right? Beta, meri awaaz audible hai, clear to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Theek hai, thank you, Beta. So when to use passive form? So I want you to answer this. Let me see how much you remember. Why we use passive forms? Tell me one by one. You can raise hand and I'll ask you to speak. Why do we use passive form? Why not simply write it in active voice? Why to use passive form? Hurry up. Why do we use passive form? Yes, Anchal beta. You can unmute. Are you not able to unmute? Anybody else? If you remember, why do we use the passive form? Anchal, is there any problem? Harsh, you can say yes if you are ready for answer. Kashish, Khushi Chhabra, you promised to participate. Tell the answer if you can.
We want to focus attention on person or thing affecting by the.
Yes, that means you can say when the object is important. It is important to mention the object. As a Ravan was killed by Ram, so Ravan here was in focus. Good, okay. Anything else? Gurnoor, Dilpreet, Mandeep.
In order to change the manner of sentence.
Change the manner of sentence in what respect? Reason, that's what I am asking.
If we want to give attention to object in the sentence, then we can use that.
That is the first point that we have already discussed. When there is focus on the object, then we prefer to write in passive form. There are many other reasons that we use passive form. Anything else you remember? You can tell.
To make the sentence more attractive.
Yes. To make the narration a little bit interesting. If I keep on using the active form, na, the very simple example if I give you, I wake up early in the morning, I go for a morning walk, I go for my job. See how boring it sounds. But if I bring variations to it, if I use a passive form, then it becomes a little interesting. So if you are narrating something, if you are giving a speech, so to make it more attractive, passive form is preferred. Anything else there? Is there anything else that you can add?
It emphasizes the action done by a subject.
Very good. If you want to focus on the action done instead of the subject, then also we prefer passive voice. Right? Now we can say tea is grown in Assam. We don't want to add the people of Assam grow tea. No, that is not the more important fact. The importance is growing of tea in Assam. So we can write that way. Tea is grown in Assam. Anything else? Anything else you remember? Good, you are going great.
To show interest in person or object that experiences an action rather than the person.
Yes, Mandeep, it is correct. And this is the first one which we have already discussed when we focus on the object. And next one, we also prefer to write in passive form when subject is unknown. Right? I will not say somebody stole my car. Somebody. So the subject is not known there. So that way we can write my car was stolen. The action can be preferred. And when the subject is not known, we prefer the passive form to express. Right, students? So these are the quick points. So when you want to tell about an action, but you don't want to mention who does it, here you are describing the action without mentioning who actually did it. The window was broken. That means when we prefer action and we don't know who did it, then you want to emphasize the object. Okay, aap sabne discuss kiya hai. Okay? When the emphasis is on the subject, if the emphasis is on the fact that the company was sold, that the action was done, the company was sold. Who sold it is not important. So that way we express it to make the narration more interesting, to give variety to it. And when we describe procedures, cooking shows mein, right? To procedures use hote hain. So you can use passive form there. A pan is taken, the eggs are poured into it. So that way the passive form is taken. Or, and the last, when the subject or agent is not known or it is unimportant. Somebody cleaned the room. Words like people, servant. When the subject is also understood, right? So that way you can avoid using active voice. You can use passive form. So the important factor in creating passive form sentence is the third form of the verb, which is to be kept in mind. In every case, the main verb will go in third form, right? So there are certain regular and irregular verbs jinke forms ko samajhna zaruri hai. Jaise regular verbs mein kya hota hai, jaise work, worked, worked, help, helped, helped, bake, baked, baked. Inke jo second and third form hai wo similar se hote hain. So these are of category regular verb. Next are irregular verbs jinke jo second form or third form different hote hain. Bite, bit, bitten, draw, drew, drawn. And there are certain words jo in dono category mein nahi aate, jaise put, 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 cut, cut, cut. But what you do is you do cut, cut, cutted kar dete ho, putted kar dete ho, beta, bore nahi karna hai. Is baat ka dhyan rakhoge, theek hai? So let's quickly revise the rules. When we are taking the examples of present tense, how the active form is to be changed. Sorry. So in active simple present mein verb first form mein hota hai, right? The root form of the verb is there. So what do? With subject, we add is, am, are, verb in third form. In present continuous tense, is, am, are ke saath verb ing hota hai active mein. And in passive, we convert it into is, am, are, and a word is added being to show the continuous form of the verb and the verb third form. क्योंकि जब थर्ड फॉर्म लगा देते हो तो कैसे पता चलेगा ये टेंस कंटिन्यूअस है. बी ई आई एन जी, दिस इज द वर्ड विच शोज द कंटिन्यूअस फॉर्म ऑफ टेंस इन पैसिव फॉर्म. प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट को हमने क्या करना है, हैज हैव के साथ हमने बीन लगा देना है, बी डबल ई एन. एंड प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस फॉर्म इट इज नॉट यूज्ड कॉमनली, इट कैन नॉट बी एक्सप्रेस्ड इन पैसिव फॉर्म. सो लेट्स क्विकली टेक दीज एग्जाम्पल. Mother writes an email. An email is written by mother. Subject or object ke place ko interchange kiya. As per rule, agar simple present hai, root form hai, writes. Iske saath humne kya lagaya? Is. Now, ye jo humne is am are bhi lagana hai, it will agree to the subject undertaken. Ho sakta hai, main yahan likhu mother writes emails. Yahan plural ho gaya object. Emails are written by mother ho jayega fir. So you will agree to the subject, you will choose the correct helping verb and then transform it into passive form. Ram, Sam is fixing the computer. The computer is being fixed by Sam. Matlab ek action chal raha hai. John has helped Maria with a project. Maria has been helped by John with her project. So tense form is not to be changed. Tense ka form wahi rahega jo tense hai. परफेक्ट परफेक्ट में रह जाएगा, कंटिन्यूअस कंटिन्यूअस नहीं रह जाएगा, परफेक्ट परफेक्ट में रह जाएगा. यू जस्ट हैव टू ऐड द करेक्ट हेल्पिंग वर्ब, राइट? नेक्स्ट इज द पैसिव वॉइस इन पास्ट टेंस. सो एक्टिव में हमारा जो सिंपल पास्ट है वो वर्ब सेकेंड फॉर्म लेता है. तो यहाँ हम क्या करते हैं, वॉज वर्ब के साथ वर्ब थर्ड फॉर्म. Past continuous was verb ing becomes was verb being. Past perfect had verb third forms becomes had been third form. And again, this past perfect continuous is not commonly used in passive form. So these are a few examples in front of you. The man cut down the tree. The tree was cut down by man. The boys were helping the wounded man. The wounded man was being helped by the boys. He had not ironed his clothes. His clothes had not been ironed by him. So these are the ways. You will not change the tense. Uske tense ko wahi rakhna hai. Bas aapko correct helping verb lagana hai. Next is the passive voice in future tense. Simple future में होता है will shall के साथ verb one. So what you will do? Will shall के साथ you will add be and verb third form. Future continuous and future perfect continuous tense are not in common use. So only one part is left, that is future perfect tense. Will have, shall have, verb three के साथ will have been, shall have been, verb third form is to be used. So some examples, I will do it, it will be done by me, I shall have written the letter will have been written by me. Future continuous and future perfect continuous cannot be changed into passive form. And these are the rules which is in front of you. You can take the screenshot. You can prepare a table and you can just paste it on the wall where you study there. So it will be helpful. Now there are more cases when there are two objects, right? So ek object nahi hai, do object hai. So one is the direct object and another one is the indirect object. So while transforming, you have to take care by asking questions. Direct object, what ka answer dega? Indirect object, whom ka answer dega? He sent me a gift. He sent me what? A gift, right? Whom did he send a gift? To me. So whom ka answer hai? Me. And what ka answer hai? A gift. That means a gift is the direct object. Me is indirect object, right? And you can transform it in both ways, taking the direct object or indirect object. And this is the way it has to be transformed. A gift was sent to me, or I was sent a gift by him. He has lent me some money. Some money has been lent to me by him, or I have been lent some money by him. So both ways you can start the passive form, right? Now next is the interrogative form. Next is the interrogative form, which is to be taken care of. Moksh, I will repeat the rules page once again. Let me just finish it. The interrogative form is quite important to understand क्योंकि maximum गलतियां यहीं पर होती है. What you do is आप interrogative forms का answer लिख देते हो. यहाँ पर question का जवाब नहीं देना है. You just have to maintain the question form and change it into passive form. And the question form, interrogative form, that starts in two ways. One is starting with WH words. What, why, when, who, how. And starting with helping verbs, is, am, are, was, were, have, has, do, does, did. Rules, the basic rules that were same rahenge, it is that when you are starting with WH word, your sentence will begin with WH word. You have to place the correct helping verb right after the WH verb, then place the subject and then the verb in the third form. As for example, why does your brother... Please excuse. Why does your brother sing such bad songs? Why are such bad songs sung by your brother? Now see, what are the changes here? Sentence is opening with the word why. Why se hi aapka transform hoga passive mein. Does your brother sing bad song? Now what is the object here? Such bad songs, right? Your brother is the subject here. So we will interchange the position first. So such bad songs aage aa jayenge. Now as per question ka jo rule hota hai, aap apne WH ke word ke saath pehle helping verb lagate hain. Right? Agar aap aise likhte ho, why such bad songs are sung by your brother, then the answer is wrong here. Right? So aapke WH word ke saath immediately you will place the helping verb, then you will place your object, jo hai such bad songs. And as the object is in plural, although does was there in the sentence in active form, we will take the plural form of verb before object. Then the verb third form will follow, sing ka ban gaya sung by your brother. and you will add question mark. Who is doing the dishes? जब who से begin होता है, we add by whom are the dishes being done? Why have you called me here? Why have I been called here by you? Who broke the jar? By whom was the jar broken? Why were you doing the work? Why was the work being done by you? Quickly समझते हैं is, am, are, was, were, has, have, has, do, does, did. Helping verb जो है जब शुरू होता है तो helping verb से ही आएगा and rule according to the passive. But the care has to be taken when you use do, does and did. Right? जब do or does है, that means a present form का helping verb है question का. Do or does is, am, are में change हो जाएगा. Did change होगा was, were में. इस बात का ध्यान रखो. Do cats catch mice? Are mice caught by cats? Does the grocer sell tea? Is tea sold by the grocer? Right? और देखिए जो helping verb has, have, has, is, am, are से हैं वो उसी से शुरू होंगे. Has somebody broken the window? Oh, sorry, has, yes. Has the window been broken by somebody? So, has, right after that we will place the subject. Then, has के साथ हमने been लगाना है to make it in the perfect form, broken by and the object. You can avoid writing somebody as well. जब subject somebody, anybody होता है, we can avoid it. तो यहाँ पर हम simply कर सकते हैं, has the window been broken? And question mark, right? More examples. Did the policeman catch the thief? Was the thief caught by the policeman? Will the postman deliver the letter? Will the letters be delivered by postman? So see, this way you are to write your answer. So, जब do, does, did है, तो is, am, are, do, does के साथ, did के साथ, was. Other than that, जो भी helping verb से आपका sentence begin होता है, you will begin that sentence with that helping verb only. Next होते हैं imperative sentences. I think the session is coming to an end. It would be better if I discuss this part tomorrow. And we will have a lot of practice session as well. So you are going to answer all the questions that will be there on the slide. Okay? So from imperative sentence, we will continue tomorrow. I hope this part is clear to you all. Okay?